Well, Kristen, a lot of the video that you're seeing was probably shot a little earlier as the situation was unfolding. But until the first responders get an accurate handle on, you know, how many suspects are there? Where are the suspects? Did they flee the scene? Are they still in the building? They have to search everybody that comes out of that building, because pretty much everybody is treated to a great degree as a suspect until they're cleared. They want to make sure that the suspect isn't standing in line there somewhere trying to get out of the building themselves. You know, there's a possibility that perhaps, and I'm just saying perhaps, the suspect could have been a credentialed employee of the facility. So they could have very easily had gotten in one of these evacuation lines. So it's very important that anybody that leaves the building gets patted down and searched. So not only the building gets cleared, but also the perimeter and the streets are clear of people that are no longer considered suspects. Because, you know, early on, you don't know how many suspects you have. You don't know where the suspects are. So these situations are very rapidly unfolding in the eyes of the first responders. And like I said earlier, there's a lot of panic, not only on the part of the people evacuating from the building, but all the bystanders that are watching right across the street to is the Walmart.com headquarters, Walmart's facility. You know, these people are all looking out of their window, wondering what's going on, why there are 15 police cars and fire trucks and people walking out of the building with their hands up. It's very typical that the first responders, and we've seen this in past school shootings and various other mass shooting situations where you see the video of people coming out of the building, even students from schools, with their hands above their heads, with their hands up. That's because it's you have to very accurately determine who's a suspect, who's not, who's armed, who's not, and then as things progress, you get a better and better handle on the situation.
Dick, thanks very much. That's Dick Epting, our engineer here at ABC7, who has a long history of working with emergency personnel. He knows so much about the radio communications, how these things work, how the law enforcement responds.